So what is the surface of revolution of curves? So for this, first of all, you should know how do we obtain the surface area for the revolution of curves. So suppose you have some curve here and you rotate this curve about some axis, say x axis. So you would have a symmetrical figure below also. So you would have a solid with three dimensions. So this would be the solid that you would obtain, right? So this is the solid which is obtained by revolving one particular curve, this curve, y is equal to f of x about this axis. This is the x axis. So now next thing is, how can you calculate the surface area of revolution of this curve? So suppose you have some curve, or suppose you have one ice cream cone with you. So say this is the cone that you have, and you have some ice cream here on the top of it, right? So now if you are to calculate the volume, now what you have done, you have just eaten, you just ate all the ice cream which was present up here, right? So all the ice cream is available only here. So that would be calculating the volume for this whole cone. So how much ice cream is filled into this cone, that is calculating its volume. So now you have also emptied the ice cream which is present inside this cone. So in this case, you are only left with this cone, right? So now you wanted to eat this cone. So how can you eat this cone? And if you have this mathematical mind, so you will think, okay, how large is this cone? So for that, you would calculate the surface area for that particular cone. So how can you calculate the surface area? The surface area would then be calculated through the following expressions, right? So let us see how. So now, in order to calculate what is the volume for this particular cone, we will calculate the corresponding surface area. So now, suppose you have this curve, y is equal to f of x, and this is available when you rotate this curve about x axis. So in that case, what would be the surface area when the limits of this x are given from x varying from a to b? So the surface area is obtained, so the surface area that is obtained by calculating what is the circumference for this particular curve. So you take one circle. So basically what you are doing, you are taking a knife and you are just dividing this
particular curve. Ma'am, nahi aa rahi.
Okay, let me see. So here what we are to do, we are to calculate the surface area for this particular curve. So this is the given curve, and we are to calculate its surface area by rotating this curve about this x axis. So the figure would be something like this. So this is the total area that you would have, right? So this whole region would be available, and you now wanted to calculate what is this area, surface area for this particular figure. In order to understand the difference between this volume and the surface area, so you can assume that you have some ice cream cone with you, right? So now if some ice cream is being filled into this cone, so in that case you will be calculating its volume to identify how much ice cream is being filled into this particular cone. But if you are to evaluate how large is this cone without the ice cream, so that means in that case you are just seeing what is this area of this particular cone. So that is the surface area that we are required to calculate here. So in order to calculate what is the surface area, what we are doing, we are calculating the one circle over here. So we are dividing this whole thing. So suppose you have some knife and you are cutting this cone into by this plane. So suppose you are dividing this cone into half portion. So one portion is this upper portion and another portion is this lower portion. So eventually,
ma'am, screen visible.
So how can we calculate the surface area?
To calculate the surface area, what we'll do, we'll divide this whole of our object into small circles. So if you cut this particular cone through a plane, so what you are getting? You are getting this particular circle out of it, right? So in order to calculate the surface area, we'll calculate the circumference of this circle. The circumference of this circle. So what would be the circumference? If r is the radius of the circle, so the circumference would be 2 pi r, right? So now you cut this cone to some distance, say this one, and then again you will be getting some kind of circle, again you will calculate its circumference and so on. So you keep on doing this, so you have so many circles on which are lying on this particular cone, right? So you can calculate the circumference of all these particular circles, and then you could add them all. So when you add them all, you will get the surface area for this whole of this curve. So that is what we are intending to do in for calculating the surface area of the solid which is formed by revolution of certain curve. So this is the curve that is given to us. Say this is y is equal to f of x kind of curve, and we are rotating this curve about x axis. So what we are doing, we are taking a very small circle out of it, and we are calculating its distance. So the circle would be like this, right? One circle would be like this, and what would be the circumference for this circle? It would be 2 pi into this particular distance, this vertical distance. So what is this vertical distance here? It is not, say suppose this point is x comma y, so this vertical distance would be the coordinate y itself. So the circumference of one circle would be 2 pi into y. So that is for one circle. And how many such circles are present here in this particular figure? They are infinite in number. So suppose this point is A and this point is the point B, then what we'll do, we'll integrate this circumference of one circle from the limit A to B, so that we now obtain the area for this particular solid of revolution. So this is the formula that is required to calculate the surface area of revolution of this particular curve. So now if you see, it is given in terms of ds. What is ds? Ds is the area, this is the length of this arc here. So this is the length of this particular arc. So and for the purpose of visualization, I am creating this as
it is not visible.
It is not visible. So in order to calculate this surface area, and what is this integration with respect to S, ds. So for that, what I am doing, I am taking some small portion on this curve. Say this is ds, small arc length. So now this ds would be calculated. What is this ds? Let me draw it here. So this is the curve. So this is the very small portion which is present on this curve. If I draw a perpendicular from this curve, so it would be the distance, small distance dy, and if I draw a perpendicular in this direction, so this would be perpendicular, this distance would be dx. And what is this? This is ds. So now I want to calculate this ds in terms of dx and dy. So how can I do that? I can use the Pythagoras law. So that would be ds square, that would be dx square plus dy square. So from here I can calculate my the value of ds. So the value of ds, that would be nothing but dx square plus dy square square root, and I can take this dx square common from it. So it would be 1 plus dy by dx whole square and multiplied by dx square, right? So if I take this dx out from this square root, so I'll be having this term, square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square into dx. So this is what I get. So now when I substitute the value of ds to be this quantity, 1 plus dy by dx whole square square root dx, what do I have? I have the surface area of the given solid which was required. So this is the formula, and I hope this is clear to you all. So now suppose if the curve is given in parametric form, so in that case our equations of the curve are x is equal to f of t and y is equal to g of t, and t lies between t1 and t2. So in that case, the surface area is given by this expression. So how this expression is obtained? If you see the previous expression, it was nothing but integration 2 pi y into ds or into square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square multiplied by dx. Now everything here is given in terms of t, x is given in terms of t, y is also given in terms of t. So that means what is the value of y given to you? Y is given to be g of t. So this is g of t, and in place of this dy upon dx, now I will write what was this thing. This was eventually equal to this dx square plus dy square square root, right? So now, because t is a function of x is a function of t and y is also a function of t, so these quantity dx square, they now become dx upon dt whole square, and then dy square becomes dy upon dt whole square. So this is what we got in case of parametric curves. In the case of polar curves, we have the equation of curve as r is equal to f of theta, where theta lies between theta 1 and theta 2. So in that case, our integration varies from theta 2 to theta 1 to pi. And what is y here? You know, in polar coordinates, x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sine theta. So from here, we just substituted the value of y to be r sine theta. And what is this expression? This expression now becomes r square plus dr upon d theta whole square square root into d theta. So this is the expression. When you differentiate this dx this x with respect to theta, so you will have this expression. And when you differentiate this y with respect to theta, so you will have this whole term present over here. So this is the formula to calculate the surface area when the given curve is present in polar form. So let us have a look at one question. The question says, find the area of the surface of revolution which is generated by revolving about x-axis, where the arc of parabola is taken from the point x is equal to 0 to the point x is equal to 3. Parabola is given to be y square is equal to 12x. So this is given to you. You have to calculate what is the surface area of revolution. So firstly, we'll visualize what is this. This is a parabola, right? This is a right-handed parabola, and we are to calculate the surface area of revolution from the point 0 to 3. So this is the point 0, 0, and this is the point x is equal to 3. So at whenever you have the value of x is equal to 3, what is the value of y? So y would be, or in fact y square would be 12 into 3, so that would be 36. So in effect y would be 6. So the point here that we obtained is 3, 6. So this is the point, this is the equation of parabola, and to calculate the surface area, we have this y with us. We'll substitute the value of y here. It would be square root 12x, and so y here with us is square root 12x, and what is the value of this dy upon dx? That is equal to 1 divided by 2 square root 12x multiplied by the derivative of 12x, that is 12. So this 2 and 12 cancels with each other, so we are left with 6 divided by square root 12x. So that is dy by dx. So this expression, square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square, this now becomes 1 plus 6 divided by square root 12x whole square into dx. So now we can simply solve it. So 6 square would be 36, square root 12x square would be 12x. So we can simplify this. Now how to calculate the perform the integration of this term? Having power 1 by 2, its value would be the power 3 by 2, and divided by this power 3 by 2. And then you will also multiply here by the coefficient of x. So we'll multiply by the coefficient of x here, limits varying from 0 to 3. So we have, when you substitute the values of the lower limit and upper limit, you will have finally the answer as 24 2 square root 2 minus 1 square units. So this is the final answer. So next we have another question. Show that the surface area of prolate spheroid, which is formed by revolving the ellipse. So now we have this ellipse x square by a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1, having eccentricity e is this one. So now here in this case, you are given the surface area. Now you have to show that the surface area is exactly this same surface area. So for that, what we'll do, we'll first write the equation for this ellipse. Then for this ellipse, we would substitute, we will calculate the limits. How can we calculate the limits? For that, we will see at which points this curve meets the x-axis.
My screen is lagging.
You will firstly calculate what is the limits. We'll firstly calculate what are the limits. The surface area is given using this formula. So here we will find out from what limit to what limit we have to perform this integration. And then the formula is 2 pi into y square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square into dx. So for that we know what is y. We can also calculate dy upon dx. And we can substitute it here. The thing that is left is, what are these limits? This is not given to you in the question. So for that, these are the values of x where the curve meets this x-axis. So the curve meets this x-axis at this particular point and at this particular point. So for that, what we'll do, we'll substitute y as equal to 0. So when you substitute y is equal to 0 here, so you would have x square divided by a square is equal to 1, or when you solve it, you would have x is equal to plus minus a. So the curve meets x axis at this point a comma 0 and this another point minus a comma 0. So the limits of x are minus a to a. This you have to calculate all by yourself. So now this is the given curve, right? So what would be y here? So y would be 1 minus x square divided by a square and then multiplied by b square and then whole square root. So this is the value of y. So you can calculate what is this dy upon dx from here. Once you have this y, you have this dy, you have the limits, you can substitute it here and you could use this particular formula that b square is equal to a square 1 minus e square. So this formula is used to calculate the given, to eliminate this particular b from here, because in the end we are to show that it is equivalent to 2 pi a b square root of 1 minus e square plus 1 by e sine inverse of e. So this is what we are required to prove.